2021 promises to be a fruitful year for ESA and the European space industry. This year we'll see the launch of a new and innovative telecommunications satellite called Quantum, developed through a public-private partnership with Eutelsat. Quantum is the first satellite that can be reprogrammed in orbit for maximum flexibility. Another first in 2021 will be the maiden flight of Vega-C. This new iteration of the Vega launcher is more powerful and allows for larger and heavier payloads than the current Vega, with which it will share a launch pad. Vega-C's third stage motor will also be used as a strap-on booster for Europe's new heavy lift launcher, Ariane 6. The development of Ariane 6 will continue in 2021, working towards the launcher's inaugural flight in 2022. Through clever design, both Vega-C and Ariane 6 will be cost-efficient and reliable launch vehicles ready to compete in the worldwide launcher market, confirming Europe as a front-runner in spaceflight, while also securing independent access to space for Europe. Exciting news for Galileo, Europe's global satellite navigation system. In January, the contract for the development of the second-generation Galileo satellites will be signed. Europe will also launch two first-generation Galileo satellites on a Soyuz from Kourou in 2021. These satellites are set to serve as backups or replacements for the oldest Galileo satellites. As humankind continues to face the challenge of climate change and our impact on the environment, Earth observation continues to be a cornerstone of ESA's activities. The agency will carry on operating 16 Earth observation satellites monitoring our planet. Through these programs, over 250 terabytes of data are distributed to users across the globe for scientific and operational purposes. In the coming year, ESA and the European Commission will also decide on the expansion of Europe's successful Copernicus Earth Observation Programme. In 2021, two ESA astronauts will launch to the International Space Station. Thomas Pesquet will start his second long-duration mission in spring. His mission is called Alpha, after Alpha Centauri, the closest stellar system to Earth, following the French tradition to name space missions after stars or constellations. In autumn, German astronaut Matthias Maurer will fly to the space station for his first mission, called Cosmic Kiss, which represents the love of space. Matthias was the most recent astronaut to join the ESA Astronaut Corps and finished basic training in 2018. In 2021, ESA will start recruitment to find suitable candidates for a new astronaut class. Aboard the ISS, both Thomas and Matthias will spend a lot of time in the European Columbus Laboratory, performing hundreds of experiments in zero gravity. ESA will continue to collaborate with NASA in human spaceflight with the ongoing development of NASA's Artemis 1 mission. The Artemis 1 mission will see the first flight of the new Orion capsule with ESA's European Service Module, ESM. The Orion spacecraft and ESM will become vital for human spaceflight, as they will fly astronauts to the future Lunar Orbiting Gateway, in which ESA is one of the contributing partners, but also to the Moon or even to Mars. While it might be a while before humans set foot on it, the exploration of the Red Planet presses forward with the continued development of ExoMars, ESA's Mars lander and rover, scheduled for launch in 2022, and the Mars Sample Return Mission, in collaboration with NASA, that aims to retrieve samples from our neighbouring planet. A lot further into space, ESA's spacecraft BepiColombo and Solar Orbiter will perform a near-simultaneous flyby of Venus in August. It will be the second flyby of the hottest planet in our solar system for both spacecraft. BepiColombo is on a 7-year journey to Mercury, and Solar Orbiter will be the first spacecraft to study the poles of our Sun. Science will also see the launch of the James Webb Space Telescope on top of an Ariane 5 from Kourou. This infrared telescope will study every phase in the history of our universe, ranging from the first luminous glows after the Big Bang to the formation of solar systems capable of supporting life on planets like Earth. Closer to home, ESA's FlyEye telescope will be tested and validated at Matera Space Center in Italy. This telescope has been specially designed to scan the heavens for near-Earth objects such as asteroids, which could potentially be a threat to our planet. June 2021 will mark the end of an era, when current ESA Director General Jan Wörner ends his tenure. Jan became ESA Director General in July 2015. At the time, he was the head of the German space agency DLR. With Jan as Director General, ESA saw a number of achievements, like securing a record budget at the Space 19 Plus Summit in Seville, Spain, and a renaissance in Europe's space industry, due in large to Jan's insistence that the private sector should play a larger part in Europe's space ambitions. Now it will be up to a new Director General, Josef Aschbacher, and a younger generation to take over and lead the European Space Agency into the future.